Okay. Here, projection up on inclined plane. You see, suppose there is an inclined plane. There is an inclined plane. So this is here. You see, this is an inclined plane. AB is the inclined plane. AC is the horizontal. An inclined plane makes an angle alpha with horizontal. So this is the inclined plane. From the bottom of the inclined plane, one body is thrown into space with a velocity say u at an angle of projection. Angle of projection means that is always measured with respect to horizontal, from the horizontal. So that is theta. Okay, here one body is projected into the space at an angle of projection theta with the horizontal. Okay, now here in this case, the projection up on inclined plane. So that this body is projected upwards on inclined plane. Then this body travel along the parabolic path, like this. And if the inclined surface is not there, it reaches the ground. But as the inclined surface is there, here, it strikes the inclined plane. It strikes the inclined plane like this at the point say B. So in this case, what is the time taken by this projectile to reach the inclined plane? What is the distance traveled by this projectile on inclined plane before it reaches the inclined plane? That means this is called range on inclined plane. At the same time, what is the distance traveled along horizontal direction before the projectile reaches the inclined plane? At that time, what is the horizontal distance traveled? The horizontal distance traveled is equal to say AC. AC is the horizontal distance traveled. Okay, so we have to derive the formulas for this. Okay, for that, here you imagine that here, all of you listen carefully, because the problem is simple. If you listen carefully, okay, here you treat this inclined plane as x-axis. You treat this inclined plane is along x-axis. Perpendicular to this inclined plane or normal to inclined plane, you imagine y-axis. Okay. So you treat this inclined plane along x-axis, and a normal to inclined plane or perpendicular to inclined plane, there is a y-axis. So now this becomes an origin. A is the origin here. Okay. Now at this point, so A is the origin. You see, here, whenever the body is projected from the point A, at that time, what is the acceleration action on the body? Along which direction acceleration acts on the body at A? When the projectile is at A, what is the direction of acceleration acts on the body? That is Z. Is it downwards or upwards? Downwards. Very good. So here, acceleration acts on the body is in downwards direction, G. Okay, now you resolve this acceleration due to gravity into two components. One component is along x-axis, another component is along y-axis. As we imagine this as x-axis and this as y-axis, so along x and y-axis, you resolve the acceleration due to gravity into components. If it is alpha, because this is alpha, no? If it is alpha, this is 90 minus alpha, because these two are perpendicular. Okay, if it is 90 minus alpha, as these two are perpendicular, this is equal to alpha. Now you tell me, what is the component of acceleration due to gravity in this direction? That is G. What is the component of acceleration due to gravity in this direction? G. G cos alpha. Okay, here it is G cos alpha. And this component is? This component is G sine alpha. Okay, G sine alpha. Okay, now here the angle of projection, that means the angle made by this direct velocity of the projectile with horizontal is theta, and angle of inclination, means angle made by inclined surface with horizontal is alpha. Then what about this angle? Theta minus alpha, no? Theta minus alpha. So this is equal to theta minus alpha. Now, at this point of projection or at the bottom of the inclined plane, you resolve this velocity into two components along x-axis, along y-axis. So along x-axis, you see, as the velocity in this direction, the components are also away from the body. Away from this body means in this direction. So x component in this direction, y component in this direction. What is the x component? As angle made by this velocity direction with this x-axis or with the inclined plane is theta minus alpha, this component is equal to u cos theta minus alpha. And vertical component is u sine theta minus alpha. Okay. Now, you see, whenever the body travels from this point to this point, what is the time taken we have to find? That's why here, first point, in this we have to learn time of flight or time taken by the projected body to reach the inclined plane. Time taken by the body to reach inclined plane. To reach inclined plane. To reach the inclined plane. You say capital T because that is the time of flight on the inclined plane. Okay. So what is the formula for this? We have to derive. Okay. So here, whenever the body reaches the inclined plane here at B, then displacement along y-axis becomes zero, no? When the body reaches the inclined plane, then the displacement along y-axis becomes zero, no? Okay, so here, whenever the body reaches the inclined plane, it reaches the x-axis. So y-coordinate is zero, no? That means the y along y-axis displacement is zero, no? That's why you consider that concept along y-axis. Because when the body reaches the inclined plane here, as the displacement along y-axis is zero, that value we know because that is zero. That's why along y-axis you consider the different parameters. Along y-axis. Initial velocity. Along y-axis initial velocity is equal to u sine theta minus alpha. Okay. Next, acceleration. Acceleration A is equal to, you see, initial velocity is along this direction, but acceleration of the body opposite to this acceleration component along y-axis is equal to g cos alpha. That is opposite to this initial velocity component. That's why minus g cos alpha we have to write. Whenever it reaches the inclined plane or x-axis, the displacement along y-axis is equal to zero. When the body reaches the inclined plane, the displacement along y-axis is zero. Okay. And time taken is equal to, right here, whenever the projectile reaches the inclined plane, then along y-axis displacement is zero. That's why displacement is zero. Then to travel from this point to this point, what is the time taken? The time taken t is equal to capital T, which is equal to cos mark. So what is the relation among them? Initial velocity is known, acceleration, displacement, time taken. The relation among them means the s is equal to ut plus half it square, no? From S is equal to ut plus half at square. From this formula, S means 0, u means u sine theta minus alpha into t, capital T, minus half a means minus g cos alpha minus g cos alpha into t square. Okay, you bring this half g cos alpha into t square to left, then 1 by 2 into g cos alpha into t square is equal to u sine theta minus alpha into capital T. The t square cancel. Therefore, capital T is equal to 2u cross multiplication. 2u sine theta minus alpha whole by g cos alpha. Okay. This is the formula for time of flight or time taken by the body to reach the inclined plane. It is also called as the time of flight on inclined plane. Time of flight on inclined plane. Okay, 2u sin theta minus alpha, 2u sin theta minus alpha by g cos alpha. Okay. Now, during this time, what is the distance traveled by the body along inclined plane? That is called range on inclined plane. During this time, what is the distance traveled by the body along the inclined plane? Or before the body reaches the inclined plane, what is the distance traveled by the body along inclined plane? That is called range of the body on inclined plane. So next one, range of the body on an inclined plane. Range of the body on an inclined plane, that is Kepler. Okay. Now, time taken by the projectile to reach the inclined plane is equal to this one. No? During this time, what is the distance traveled by the body along the inclined plane? During this time means the body reaches the point here. So during this time, what is the distance traveled by the body along the inclined plane means that is equal to AB. No? So what is AB? So we have to derive the formula for AB. Okay, what about video? Student friends, is it visible to you clearly or not? Okay, Vamshi Krishna, you check your mobile. Okay, right. Okay, thank you. Right, here along x-axis or along incline. Along x-axis or along incline. Okay, you see along incline. At the point, at the instant whenever it is projected, what is the velocity component along inclined plane? What is the velocity component along inclined plane at initial? At initial means at A. What is the velocity component of the body along incline? Tell me. U cos. This one, no? U cos theta minus alpha. Okay. So along incline, the initial velocity is u cos theta minus alpha. Okay, acceleration along this direction, velocity component is considered. So along this direction, what is the acceleration? You see, acceleration due to gravity component g sin phi sin alpha is in opposite direction, no? Compared with velocity component in this direction. That's why acceleration is minus g sin alpha. So minus g sin alpha. Okay, are you following? Minus g sin alpha, no? Pranav. Okay. Right. Next, time taken is equal to capital T. Time taken is equal to this only. We have substituted that value. Okay. Next, what is the distance traveled in this time along the x-axis? That means S is equal to AB, which is equal to range on inclined plane. That is equal to question mark. Okay. What is the relation among them? Again, same formula. Okay. From S is equal to UT plus half at square. S means range or u means u cos theta minus alpha into capital T plus half a means minus g sin alpha into t square. Okay. Now range r is equal to u cos theta minus alpha into whatever t. From this equation one, t means 2u sin theta minus alpha by g cos alpha. Okay. Next, already instead of t we have substituted minus half g sin alpha into t means this one. So square is there. That's why you write 4 u square sin square theta minus alpha whole by g square cos square alpha. Okay. Here g square cancel. Okay. Now range r is equal to here 2 u square 2 into u into u, u square 2 u square sin theta minus alpha into cos theta minus alpha, okay, by z cos alpha minus in this here 2 2s are cancel, okay, therefore 2 u square into here sin square theta minus alpha into sin alpha whole by g cos square alpha. Okay, in both the terms, we can take 2 u square common, by g cos square alpha also you take common, g cos square alpha you take common. Okay, then what you will get? Okay, 2 u square, you see 2 u square by g cos square alpha you take common, then remainder 2 u square by g cos square alpha you have taken common. Okay, only one cos alpha is there. To take cos square alpha common here we have to multiply with cos alpha, then remaining is sin theta minus alpha into cos theta minus alpha into cos alpha. Okay, minus we have taken 2 u square by g cos square alpha comma, remainder is only these two. No, so sin square theta minus alpha into sin alpha. Okay, now you see r is equal to here in this sin theta minus alpha term is there, here also sin theta minus alpha term is there. In both the terms we can take one sin theta minus alpha common, so remaining is 2 u square sin theta minus alpha by g cos square alpha into cos theta minus alpha into cos alpha, cos theta minus alpha into cos alpha minus sin theta minus alpha sin alpha, sin theta minus alpha into sin alpha. Okay, cos a cos b minus sin a sin b, cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Raja Abhishek, where you could not understand? Raja Abhishek, come on, you respond immediately. Raja Abhishek, where you could not understand? Yeah. Here cos a cos b minus sin a sin b means cos of a plus b, no, cos of a plus b. That's why this is equal to 2 u square sin theta minus alpha by g cos square alpha into cos a cos b minus sin a sin b means cos of a plus b. Cos of a plus b means theta minus alpha plus alpha, theta minus alpha plus alpha. Here plus alpha minus alpha cancel, therefore r is equal to 2 u square sin theta minus alpha into cos theta whole by g cos square alpha. Okay, 2 u square sin theta minus alpha, 2 u square sin theta minus alpha into cos theta by g cos square alpha. So this is the one type of formula for range of the projectile. Okay, 2 u square sin theta minus alpha cos theta by g cos square alpha, it is one form. This is equation 2. It is equation 2. Raja, you took cos theta minus alpha. Yeah, here this one. Okay, Raja Abhishek, I will meet off you. Just you interact with me orally.
Hello, sir.
Tell me what, where is your, you are having doubts?
There, x-axis you took a u cos in diagram, sir. There you took a u cos theta minus alpha, no, sir.
Okay,
That one, have you got it, sir? I didn't understand.
You see, the body is projected with an angle of projection theta with a horizontal, okay? This body is projected in this direction by making an angle theta with a horizontal. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now this inclined plane makes an angle alpha with a horizontal. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now what is the direction of this projection with inclined plane? This theta minus alpha gives this angle, no?
Yes, sir.
Theta minus alpha. Now the body is projected with a velocity u here. Then what is the component of this velocity along the inclined plane? As okay, angle sir. Theta minus alpha. U cos theta minus alpha. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Right, Nana. Okay. Very good.
Okay.
Right. Here, this is the formula for range of the projectile. Okay. Range of the projectile on inclined plane. Okay. Now, just we have to modify this one. Here you see r is equal to u square. Just here in this 2u square sin theta minus alpha cos theta by g cos square alpha, just you keep u square aside. U square into 2 sin theta minus alpha into cos theta by g cos square alpha. G cos square alpha. Just I modified the form. Okay, now it is just like 2 sin a cos b. 2 sin a cos b. 2 sin a cos b means sin a plus b plus sin a minus b we can write now. Sin a plus b minus sin a minus b we can write. Here, this is equal to u square by g cos alpha into you see, here 2 sin a cos, it is just like 2 sin a cos b in the numerator. In the numerator, yeah, I will send the notes. I already sent, I think. Now, 2 sin theta, here you say theta minus alpha as A and theta as B. Then 2 sin A cos B. How we can write 2 sin A cos B? Sin A plus B minus sin A minus B, we can write now. Sin A plus B, sin A plus B minus sin A minus B, we can write now. You write like that. Sin A plus B means. Sin a plus b means we can write sin theta minus alpha sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. You have to write. Okay. Sin a plus b. Okay. You take this as sin a and it is a, it is b because it is greater, no? So sin a plus b means theta plus theta minus alpha. Okay. Next. Minus sin a minus b, that means sin theta minus alpha whole by g cos square alpha. Already I have written. So this is equal to u square by g cos square alpha into, tell me sin, you see sin 2 theta minus alpha, no, here sin 2 theta minus alpha. Sin 2 theta minus alpha. Here you see theta plus theta, 2 theta minus alpha. So sin 2 theta minus alpha minus here minus theta plus theta cancel, minus half minus plus alpha. So sin alpha. This is here, therefore range R is equal to, just I am writing the same here. u square into in brackets sine 2 theta minus alpha minus sine alpha whole by g cos square alpha. Okay, this is the formula for another form of the range of the projectile. Of course, this is only correct. This is just modified as like this. This is modified like this. Okay, this equation is correct. This equation also same, but just to rearrange them. Okay, that's why this is also correct. This is another form of the range of the projectile. Suppose if alpha is equal to 0, what happens? If you put alpha is equal to 0, then what is the formula for range? If you put alpha is equal to 0, then what is the what happens there? You tell me. If you put alpha is equal to 0, then u square into sine 2 theta, it is 0. So sine 2 theta by g cos square alpha. No, alpha 0 means cos alpha 1. No, that's why u square sine 2 theta by g. Already alpha is equal to 0 means this inclined plane is along horizontal. In that case, just it becomes an oblique projectile. Whatever the concept we discussed in previous classes, that becomes like that. That's why you will get u square sine 2 theta by g only, simply. Okay, that's why it is the most general formula for range of the projectile on inclined plane. Okay, next, third case, C, maximum range, R max. In this formula, for range to be maximum, what about the values? In this formula, for range to be maximum, what is the condition? For range to be maximum, here as subtraction is there, this would be maximum. Whenever the sine value is maximum, then R value becomes maximum. That's why for maximum range, for R is equal to R max, then sine of 2 theta minus alpha must be 1. That is maximum. Sine value is maximum, only 1. No, that's why whenever this value becomes maximum, this bracket term becomes maximum, so that range will be maximum. That means in order to have the maximum range on inclined plane, then sine 2 theta minus alpha is equal to 1, or 2 theta minus alpha is equal to 90 degree. Now we substitute the data here. Therefore, R max is equal to from 3, R max is equal to u square into it becomes 1, sine 91, because sine 2 theta minus alpha 1 minus sine alpha by cos square alpha. Okay, R max is equal to u square into 1 minus sine alpha by, here this can be written as 1 minus sine square alpha. No, cos square alpha can be written as sine square alpha. Okay, therefore R max is equal to u square into 1 minus sine alpha by, I think here g is there. No, g is there. Okay, g into here a square minus b square, it is just like a square minus b square. So a plus b into a minus b. A plus b means 1 plus sine alpha into 1 minus sine alpha, we can write. Here 1 minus sine alpha, 1 minus sine alpha cancel. Therefore R max is equal to, okay, u square by g into 1 plus sine alpha. It is the formula for maximum range. It is equation 4. It is the formula for maximum range. Maximum range is u square by g into 1 plus sine alpha. Here whenever inclined plane is along horizontal, then alpha is equal to 0. When you substitute alpha is equal to 0, sine 0, 0, so u square by g. Already in case of oblique projectile, maximum range is equal to u square by g only, no? Maximum projectile is equal to u square by g only, no? So already in oblique projectile, we got the same. But as it is the inclined plane, we got 1 plus sine alpha. This formula is also very, very important. Okay, next. What about the maximum height reached on the inclined plane? Maximum height reached on the inclined plane. So this is the formula for range. Okay. Next, what about the maximum height reached on the inclined plane? Fourth one. Maximum height reached by the body on an inclined plane. On an inclined plane. That is capital H. So maximum height reached by the body on an inclined plane. Okay. So here you see. On inclined plane, maximum height means on inclined plane exactly whenever the body is here, then the height is maximum. After that, the gradually it comes down. That's why height decreases. So this is the maximum height. What is that maximum height? We have to find. Okay. Suppose this is A, B, C. This point is a D. D point is the highest point on the inclined plane. Highest point of the path along which the body travels from the inclined plane. This we have to find. How we can find? How we can derive the formula for maximum height? How we can find the formula for maximum height? This height h is along y-axis now. This height h is along y-axis. That means normal to inclined plane. So along y-axis we have along y-axis. When you consider the motion along y-axis, then whenever the this projectile reaches this point, here the velocity is along horizontal direction. That means along this direction, at this point, velocity becomes zero. No? So at the highest point, along y-axis, the velocity becomes zero. Okay. Now, maximum height. You see, along y-axis. Along y-axis. Initial velocity. Initial velocity means here, at the point of projection. Initial velocity along y-axis is u sine of theta minus alpha. Okay. Acceleration. As the initial velocity of this projectile along y-axis is along positive axis, but acceleration is in downwards direction, in this direction of along y-axis, what is the acceleration? G cos alpha. That is opposite to the velocity component. That's why minus G cos alpha. Okay. Whenever it reaches the highest point above the inclined plane, at this point, it has no velocity component along this direction, because at this highest point, when you draw the tangent, this tangent becomes parallel to inclined plane. That's why the motion of the projectile at this point is parallel to inclined plane. So along perpendicular direction or along y-axis at this point, no velocity is there. So along y-axis at this point, velocity is equal to zero. So v is equal to vy, that is equal to zero. Before there, velocity along y-axis becomes zero at this point. Along y-axis, whatever the distance traveled, that is equal to maximum height reached. So S is equal to capital H. Okay. Are you followed this data? How I have noted? Are you followed this one? If you followed the data, substitution only, that's nothing. Okay. Right. Now, what is the formula to be used? The relation among them is V square minus U square is equal to 2AS from this formula. V square minus U square is equal to 2AS formula. V square means 0 minus U square means U square sine square theta minus alpha, because U means this one, you know, is equal to 2 into A means minus G cos alpha into S means maximum height. Here minus minus cancel. So H is equal to how much? H is equal to U square sine square theta minus alpha by 2 into G cos alpha. This is the formula for maximum height reached over the inclined plane. Suppose the inclined plane is along horizontal. In such case, alpha is equal to 0. When alpha is equal to 0, then the body becomes an ordinary projectile, oblique projectile. You put alpha is equal to 0. When alpha is equal to 0, it is u square sine square theta by 2g into alpha is equal to 0 means cos 0, 1. That's why u square sine square theta by 2g. That is only the formula we got there, no? Williams, John Williams. What is our doubt? John Williams. At a highest point, at this, highest point means it is not horizontal. If it is along horizontal, now velocity component is u cos theta only, because angle made by this body with the horizontal theta. That's why along this direction component is u cos theta along horizontal. At this point it is not horizontal, it is parallel to inclined plane but not horizontal. Okay, okay, John William, not Dinesh, are you okay now? Okay, John William, what is your doubt? Okay, you see here at this point the velocity of the body, John William, listen carefully, at this highest point the velocity of the body is along the tangential direction, means along this direction, that is parallel to inclined plane. Suppose if it is having velocity in this direction also, then it will rise to some more extent, but it is not rising beyond this point, it comes down, means at this point the velocity is along tangential direction, means in this direction, that is parallel to inclined plane. That's why perpendicular to inclined plane at this point the velocity is zero. No, okay, John William, right? Okay, this is the formula for maximum height reached by the body. Okay, next, fifth one, whenever the body reaches the point B after capital T seconds, capital T means time of flight time, what is the horizontal distance traveled and what is the vertical distance traveled? Vertical distance means, you see, this is the horizontal distance. Okay, when body reached the inclined plane, at B, whose coordinates are, the coordinates of B, okay, when it reaches the inclined plane at B, then what is the distance, what is the distance traveled along horizontal direction, means AC is equal to question mark, at the same time BC is equal to question mark. That is the case, AC is equal to question mark, BC is equal to question mark. Already we know AB is equal to range, you know, this AB is equal to range, you know, range on inclined plane. When it is the range on inclined plane, then what about AC? Inclined plane makes an angle alpha with horizontal direction, then this is R, then R cos alpha is equal to AC, no? So AC is equal to R cos alpha, because in this right angle triangle this is equal to range on inclined plane. Already we derived formula, this angle is alpha, then for this alpha adjacent side we need, that's why we take cos alpha. Cos alpha is equal to AC by hypotenuse means capital R, or AC is equal to R cos alpha, no? Similarly BC is equal to R sin alpha. BC is equal to R sin alpha. Here this AC can also be written as, AC is equal to R cos alpha, that is one formula, that is also equal to, you see, in capital T seconds, whenever the body reaches the point B, during the time, what is the horizontal distance traveled, means horizontal component of velocity is u cos theta, no? With this velocity in a time capital T seconds, what is the distance traveled, means along horizontal direction, there is no change in the velocity. That's why u cos theta into time of flight, or time taken by the body to reach this point, that is capital T, that is AC. Next, BC means, already I said, the component of this range along vertical direction here is equal to R sin alpha, no? So R sin alpha. These are the formulas for here. These are the coordinates of this point B also, because this distance is equal to R sin alpha, this distance is equal to R, this R cos alpha or U cos theta into T. These are the coordinates of the point B. Suppose if this is origin, then these are coordinates of the point B. In such a way also we can find. In this way, so based on this concept, we have to do some problems. The same concept. Here suppose the body is projected from the top. The body will be projected from the top. Then they travel along the parabolic path like this. Then at what distance along the inclined plane it reaches, and what is the time taken? Okay, in that way they may ask. Okay, here I don't want to say the concepts again. We will do the problem. When the body is projected from the top of the inclined plane, then what is the range along the inclined plane, time taken to reach the inclined plane, etc. We will discuss. Same, the inclined plane must be taken along x-axis and the normal to inclined plane must be taken along y-axis. Okay, now we will do some problems. Now we will do some problems. Okay. Right. Now we'll do one problem. One example. We'll discuss some few examples. 2-3 examples we have to do now. Okay. Here a particle is projected. A particle is projected. Here only 2-3 problems are there. That's why I cannot share now. Okay, just you see the problem. A particle is projected along an inclined plane, as shown in figure. Okay. What is the speed of the particle when it collides at a point? What is speed of the particle when it collides at point A? Here, a particle is projected along the inclined plane as shown in the figure. What is the speed of the particle when it collides at point A? So your diagram is given in the problem. So here, this is horizontal plane. This is the inclined plane. Here the inclined plane makes an angle 30 degree with horizontal. So alpha is equal to 30 degree. Okay. The body is projected here from the inclined plane. The body is projected with a velocity u is equal to 10 meter per second by making an angle 30 degree with inclined plane. Here this angle is the angle made by the direction of projection with inclined plane, not with horizontal. That is important. Okay, this is a beta. Okay, now here of course g is equal to 10 meter per second square is given in the problem only. It is given. Okay, now what about the velocity of the part? Well, here this particle travel along the parabolic path like this, and it reaches the inclined plane at this point. Say this is the point A. At this point, what is the velocity of the particle? That is a question they asked. Here at this point, you see, actually before making collision, the direction of motion of the particle is along this direction. Okay, now along inclined plane, what is the velocity? Normal to inclined plane, what is the velocity? We have to find. This they asked. At point A, with what velocity it collides the point A on the inclined plane? That is the question. Okay. Now, you see. Here this is say O, this is A, this is B. B is the horizontal. Okay, now you take this. Suppose whenever the problems are asked with inclined planes like this, immediately along inclined plane must be along x-axis, perpendicular to inclined plane. You take the y-axis. All of you stop video sharing. If I see the video sharing, I will remove from the class. Okay, you see, here you take this inclined plane. You take this inclined plane as x-axis, perpendicular to inclined plane as y-axis, as usual. Okay. At this point, what is the acceleration? Acceleration always acts vertically downwards direction, g. Now, you resolve this acceleration due to gravity into components. One component is along x-axis, another component is along y-axis. If it is alpha is equal to 30 degree, it is 60. Then it is 30, no? Because these two are perpendicular. If it is 60, it is 30. Now, this component is equal to g cos 30. And this component is g sin 30. G sin 30. Okay. Suppose if the velocity of the body at this point is v, then their component along this direction. What about the angle? That is important. Here, what about this angle? You see, it is alpha. Okay. If it is 30 degree, then it is 60, no? It is 60. It is 30 means it is 60. What about the angle made here? We have to find. To find the angle made, first we have to find what is the time taken by this body to reach this point. First we have to find their component along this direction is say Vx, and component of this one along this one, along this direction is say Vy, because perpendicular to inclined plane, that direction is equal to y, that is direction is the y-axis. We have considered that as y-axis. Perpendicular to this inclined plane or normal to inclined plane, we have considered the y-axis. That's why the component of this velocity along y-axis Vy and along x-axis Vx. You find Vx and Vy. Then if you know Vx and Vy, then we can find the resultant velocity V, no? So resultant velocity V is equal to square root of Vx square plus Vy square. So we have to find Vx and Vy. Now to find Vx, first of all, what is the time taken by this projectile to reach the inclined plane at the point A? So to find the time taken by the particle to reach the inclined plane at the point A, whenever it reaches the point A here, along y-axis displacement is zero. So we know that data. That's why along y-axis you consider. Along y-axis. When along y-axis, if you note the data, and if you find the time taken by the body to reach this one, then along x-axis, what is the velocity after this time? Along y-axis, what is the velocity after this time? We can find. That's why we had to find the time taken. So along y-axis, initial velocity. You see, as we have projected with a velocity 10 meter per second in this direction, their component along the inclined plane. Along inclined means along x-axis. That is, angle made by this velocity with inclined plane is 30. That's why it is equal to u cos 30. Of course, u cos 30 means 10 cos 30. Directly right. 10 cos 30. Okay, and this direction, the velocity is 10 sin 30. So this velocity is 10 sin 30. 10 sin 30. Okay. Now along y-axis, initial velocity is 10 sin 30. Initial velocity along this direction is equal to uy is equal to 10 sin 30. That is equal to 5 meter per second now. Next, acceleration. Acceleration along y-axis. Here, as we have considered the initial direction of motion, initial component of velocity along this direction, acceleration is opposite to that one. That's why minus g cos 30. Minus g cos 30. Minus g means 10 given. Cos 30 means root 3 by 2. That is equal to minus 5 into root 3 meter per second square. It is the acceleration along y-axis. Whenever it reaches the point A, then displacement along y-axis is 0, no? Whenever it reaches the point A, that lies on x-axis. That's why along y-axis, displacement is 0, no? Then what is the time taken for this? That is we have to find. So what is the relation among them? From s is equal to ut plus half 8 square, no? S is equal to ut plus half 8 square. S means 0, u means 5, t plus half a means minus half into 5 root 3. Minus 5 root 3, a means into t square. Okay, therefore, 5 root 3 by 2 t square is equal to 5 into t. Here t square cancel, therefore small t is equal to 5 cancel, therefore 2 by root 3 seconds. This is the time taken by the body to reach the inclined plane. They may ask the question like this also, even in advance also, they may ask the question directly like this also. Time taken by the particle to reach the inclined plane is equal to how much? They may ask directly like this, 2 by root 3 we got. So in this time, what is the velocity acquired by the particle along x-axis and along y-axis? So along x-axis. So in the same case, along y-axis. Already we have noted, no? Along y-axis. Now you see, along y-axis, initial velocity is along y-axis, what is the velocity? Along y-axis, what is the velocity component? Vy is equal to question mark. So from V is equal to U plus AT. V means along here, whenever the particle reaches the point here, Vy we need. So Vy is equal to U means initial velocity along y-axis 10 sine 30. Of course, 10 sine 30 means already we got 5, no? You write 5 directly. So 5. Minus A means, A is this one, minus 5 root 3. Into T means 2 by root 3. So root 3 cancel. Therefore, Vy is equal to minus 5 meter per second, no? Minus sign represents the velocity at this point along y-axis is opposite to this velocity, means in this direction. So Vy, we got 5 meter per second. Okay, next, what about the Vx value? Similarly, we had find Vx value. Vx means along x-axis. So along x-axis or along incline. Along x-axis. Initial velocity along x-axis is 10 cos 30. So along x-axis, initial velocity is equal to 10 cos 30. That is equal to 10 into cos 30 root 3 by 2. So 5 root 3. 5 root 3 meter per second. Acceleration along x-axis. Here, initial velocity along inclined plane or along x-axis in this direction. Whereas the acceleration component is opposite. That's why minus g sine 30. That is equal to minus g means 10 into sine 30 1 by 2. So minus 5 meter per second square, no? Next, time taken by the body to reach this point along incline, time taken by this body to reach this point t is equal to, we got 2 by root 3. In this time, at this point, whenever the body reaches this point, then what is the velocity along x-axis? So v is equal to vx, that is equal to question mark. What is the relation among them? V is equal to u plus at, no? Isn't it? From v is equal to u plus at, v means vx, u means 5 root 3, plus a means minus 5, into t means 2 by root 3. Okay, this is equal to, you take LCM, 5 you take common, then you take LCM, root 3. Root 3 into root 3 means 3 minus 2. That is equal to 5 by root 3 now. Therefore, vx is equal to 5 by root 3 meter per second. Already Vy we got, Vx is equal to 5 by plus 5 by root 3 means that velocity component is in this direction. Vy is not minus means that velocity is in this direction. Therefore, as these two are perpendicular, the resultant of these two is V, no? Therefore, V is equal to V at A. V at A is a Va. Va is equal to Va is equal to square root of x component square plus y component square. That is called square root of x component square means 25 by 3. Plus y component means this one, 5 square means 25. Therefore, that is equal to square root of 100 by 3, no? Because when you take LCM, 75 plus 25, 100 by 3. That is equal to, therefore, Va is equal to 10 by root 3 meter per second. So, velocity of the body when it reaches the point A is 10 by root 3 meter per second. 10 by root 3 meter per second. This is the value. This is the value. Next, what is the direction of this velocity? What is the direction of this velocity? What is the direction of this velocity? Suppose angle made by this velocity Va with inclined plane is say alpha, it is beta. Okay, it is say theta naught or theta A. At A, angle made by this velocity direction with the inclined plane, with x-axis or with inclined plane is say theta A. Then how we can find that theta A? Here you see, by taking this Vx and Vy as the adjacent sides, when you construct the parallelogram like this, when you construct the parallelogram like this, it is Vx, it is Vy. Okay, now tan theta A is equal to Vy by Vx, no? tan theta A is equal to, here tan theta A is equal to Vy by Vx. Because you see, in this right angle triangle, tan theta is equal to opposite side means this side is parallel to Vy. Okay, that's why Vy. By adjacent means in this direction, velocity Vx is there. That's why Vx. So Vy means, what is Vy we got? Minus phi. So you write minus phi. By Vx means 10 by root 3. 10 by root 3 means into root 3. 5 2s are. Therefore, minus root 3 by 2. Therefore, theta A is equal to tan inverse of minus tan inverse of root 3 by 2. So minus sign represents with x-axis in clockwise direction. That means in downwards direction, the velocity direction makes this much angle, tan inverse root 3 by 2. So tan inverse root 3 by 2 is the answer. Okay. That is one problem. Is it correct? Vy, what is the Vy value we got? Vy is equal to 5 by root 3, no? Sorry, here you see, Vx is 5 by root 3, no? Vx is equal to 5 by root 3 we got, not 10 by root 3, 5 by root 3. You see, here Vy means minus 5 only. Vx means this one, I substituted this one. This one is the answer, value. Vx means 5 by root 3. That is equal to minus root 3. Therefore, theta A is equal to minus 60 degree. Root 3 means 60. Minus is there, so minus 60 degree. Minus 60 means that represents with x-axis in clockwise direction, the velocity makes an angle 60 degree. So this is 60. So this is the answer. This is the magnitude of velocity and it is the direction of the velocity. In this way, we have to do. Okay. Okay, Karthi, you speak. What is your doubt?
Sir, at point A. Sir, you took Vy in downward direction, sir.
Yeah.
When we consider along y-axis, then we have to consider minus Vy, no, sir, while calculating.
Here, we have considered the y, positive y-axis in this direction, negative y-axis in this direction. Vy negative means that is opposite to this direction. That's why Vy we got minus sign.
Sir, we have to substitute minus Vy is equals to minus 5, sir. Then Vy will get 5.
One minute. Minus?
Minus
it is the general formula. Tan theta is equal to y by x or y component of velocity by x component of velocity. But as it is minus, we have to substitute minus. Even you take here also, what is the angle made by this velocity with x means tan theta is equal to Vy by Vx. That is the general formula. If Vy is negative, then this velocity makes an angle something. In clockwise direction. If it is positive, in anti-clockwise direction. That's all. We should not take minus. It is the formula. Y component
sir,
by X component.
I'm saying, sir.
While calculating, I substituted minus, no?
Sir, not here, sir. While calculating along
Y axis. It is when you have considered the sign convention, while substituting the data, we have to consider the sign convention. While substituting the data only, we have to consider the sign. We had considered the sign, okay. Before writing, while writing the formula, we should not consider because it is the general formula. Is Vy is along y-axis, positive y-axis or negative y-axis, we doesn't know initially. But while substituting the data, as we got minus sign, we have substituted minus. Okay, it is the general formula. We should not substitute the sign here only. While substituting the data only, we have to substitute the sign convention. We have to use the sign convention, okay?
Okay, sir.
All right. Right. So this is one problem. I think now you are able to understand how we can approach this type of problem. Okay. Similarly, we can find the range also. To find the range along inclined plane, I will send already some problems already solved them, and in our material I send some questions also to you. So based on this concept, you do those problems today. Okay. Next here, what is the range of this projectile along inclined means? Just in this time, what is the distance traveled in this direction along x-axis? Already along x-axis here we have calculated the velocity. So along x-axis, what is the distance traveled means? S is equal to question mark. From s is equal to ut plus half h square, you do s, you find that is the range of the projectile on inclined plane, you will get. Okay. Next, what is the horizontal distance of this point? A horizontal distance means this distance they asked. This distance means this is r. R cos 30 is equal to this horizontal distance. Vertical distance means r sin 30. Already in concepts only I said. Okay. Next, one more problem. Okay. Right. Next, one more example. Example 2. Here you see, find the time of flight and range of the projectile along the inclined plane as shown. Find time of flight and range of projectile along inclined plane. Along inclined plane. So this is a question. Here diagram is given like this. Here it is the inclined plane. It is the horizontal. AB is the inclined. AB is the horizontal and AC is the inclined plane. Okay. This inclined plane makes an angle 30 degree with horizontal. The inclined plane makes an angle 30 degree with horizontal. Okay. One body is projected from this point. One body is projected along horizontal direction with a velocity u is equal to 20 meter per second. One body is projected horizontally with a velocity 20 meter per second towards left. Of course, here acceleration due to gravity can be taken as 10 meter per second square. That is also given. Okay, now what is the time of flight? Something we have to find. Okay, here this is the question given. As it is projected horizontally, definitely. This is one horizontal line, this is another horizontal line, it is the intersecting line. That's why this is also equal to 30 degree only, you know. Okay, now this projectile travel along the incline parabolic path like this and reaches the inclined plane here. So what is the time taken by the body to reach the inclined plane? We have to find. I will draw this diagram again clearly. Here, one body is projected with a velocity 20 meter per second. Angle of inclination is 30 degree. Alpha is equal to 30 degree. It is given. Okay. G is equal to 10. Okay. Now, as the, you see, from the top of the inclined plane, the body is projected horizontally or they may give the body projected like this also. The body may project like this also. Here this body travel along the parabolic path like this and reaches the ground here, reaches the inclined plane at this point. Okay, here this is the point. This is the A, this is B. Okay, this is a C. Now AB is the range on inclined plane. Range AB is equal to Kepler on inclined plane. That is question mark, because they asked for the range also. Time of flight, time taken by this body to reach the ground, to reach the inclined plane at this point, that is the time of flight. So time of flight capital T is equal to question mark. Time of flight means time taken by this projectile to travel from A to B is how much? That is the question they asked. Okay, as well here also, you take this inclined plane as x axis, and as the body is projected here, you take the y axis here. Normal to inclined plane, that is a y axis. It is x axis, it is y axis. Okay. Now, you resolve this velocity into components. To resolve the velocity into components, what is the angle made by this initial direction of motion with inclined plane? Here, as this is projected horizontally, angle made with inclined is equal to 30 only, no? Because these two are horizontal lines and it is intersecting line. That's why this is also equal to 30. Now, velocity component along this direction is u cos 30, and this is u sin 30. Okay. Now, to find the time taken, whenever the body travels from this point to this point, along y-axis, displacement becomes zero, no? Initially, the body is on x-axis. When it reaches the point here, again, the body is on x-axis. That's why displacement along y-axis becomes zero, no? That's why you take along y-axis. Tell me, along y-axis, what is the initial velocity? Initial velocity along y-axis, uy is equal to u sin 30. U means 20. 20 into sin 30 means 1 by 2. That is equal to 10 meter per second. 10 meter per second. Acceleration along y-axis. You see, whenever the body is here, acceleration g acts vertically downwards direction. Resolve them into components. One component in this direction, another component in this direction. What is this angle? If it is 30, as this is horizontal and it is vertical, this is 60. As it is 60, this and this are perpendicular. So if it is 60, it is 30. Then this component is g cos 30. And this component is g sin 30. Okay. Now, along y-axis, as the initial velocity component is along this direction upwards, the acceleration component is opposite. That's why minus g cos 30. Minus g means 10, cos 30 means root 3 by 2. That is called minus 5 root 3 meter per second square. It is the acceleration component. When it reaches the point B, then displacement S is equal to 0, no? Because initially the body is here. Finally, after time of flight, the body is here. So along y-axis, displacement 0, after time equal to time of flight. That is question mark. So what is the relation among them? S is equal to ut plus half a square, no? From S is equal to ut plus half a t square. S means 0, u means 10 into t, capital T, plus half, a means minus. So minus a half into 5 root 3 into capital T square. You bring this to left, then 5 by 2 root 3 t square is equal to 10 t. T square cancel, 5 2s are. Therefore, t is equal to 4 by root 3, no? T is equal to 4 by root 3 seconds. So time of flight is equal to 4 by root 3 seconds. Time of flight is equal to 4 by root 3 seconds. Okay. Next, what about the range? Range they asked. It is the time of flight. Time of flight is equal to 4 by root 3 seconds. Okay. Time of flight, capital T is equal to cross multiplication 4 by root 3 second. 4 by root 3 seconds. Okay. Time of flight. Next, range. Range means along x-axis, what is the distance traveled by the body during time of flight? So in this time of flight time, what is the distance traveled by the body along x-axis? That is the range. So along x-axis means along inclined plane. Initial velocity, ux is equal to u sin 30. U means 20, sin 30 means 1 by 2. That is equal to 10 meter per second. Along x-axis acceleration. Along x-axis, the acceleration component is also in the same direction, no? G cos g sin 30. So g sin 30. G means 10, sin 30, 1 by 2. So 5 meter per second square acceleration. Time. Time taken by the body to reach this point is equal to 4 by root 3. So time is equal to time of light. That is equal to 4 by root 3 second. During this time, what is the distance traveled along x-axis? That is the range. So range is S is equal to R. That is equal to question mark. That is the range along the inclined plane. What, Karthi, what is your doubts? We cannot remember formula. We should not, these problems we should not do. We should not do based on the formulas. Okay. Here, Pranav. From formulas also we can find, but we cannot remember those formulas. We will confuse. Okay, based on the concept, always we have to do for these problems. Okay, it is not the simple formula like F is equal to ma, S equal to ut plus r square like that, because these formulas already have seen. They are lengthy formulas. U square sin 2 theta minus alpha minus cos theta by g cos square theta alpha, like that formulas are there. Of course, we may remember the formulas up to this weekend exam. But after a long time, we cannot remember. That's why we should not do these problems based on formulas. Okay? Yeah. Time less means for this problem, for this type of problems, we have to spend definitely. Time management is important. In the exam hall, time management is also important. If the problem is lengthy, of course, while I am explaining here, I am writing U is equal to something, this is equal to something, this is equal to something, then formula is something like that I am writing. But we have to keep these components in your mind and directly you write S equal to ut plus half its square. Okay, S is equal to ut plus half its square, directly you keep in your mind. S is equal to U means directly you write this formula. 10, 20 cos 30. So 20 cos 30 you write. Sir, ux is, sorry, 20 sin 30, you know it is sin. This is sin. Okay, so directly you keep in your mind and directly you write the values, because it is cos means it is sin. No, now we substitute the data. From S is equal to ut plus half a t square. S means range or u means 10 into t. T means already we got 4 by root 3 plus half. A means plus a. Here you see initial velocity in downwards direction along the inclined plane, acceleration component also along the inclined plane downwards only. That's why we got positive only. So plus half a means 5 into t square means 4 by root 3 whole square. So this is equal to 40 by root 3 plus here 5 by 2 into 16 by 3. 2 8s are. So again 40 by root 3 we will get. So r is equal to 80 by root 3 you will get now, because 40 by root 3 plus 40 by root, sorry, 40 by 3 only, you know, here. Sorry. So 40 by root 3 plus 40 by 3. This is R. You simplify them. So if you simplify them, you will get answer. Okay. What is u cos 30? Sorry. Here I, okay. Right. This is, this component, it is divided into components, no? So it is u cos only. U cos 30, okay. I thought that it is z. Okay. G sin 30, okay. Now u cos 30. U cos 30 means here. U cos 30. U means 20. Cos 30 means root 3 by 2. So 10 root 3 meter per second. Okay. Now we substitute the data here. S means range. U means 10 root 3 into t means 4 by root 3 plus half a means 5 root 3 square t square means 4 by root 3 whole square means 16 by 3. So here root 3 cancels, so we will get 40 plus 2 8s are. Okay, therefore 40 by 3. So r is equal to, when you take LCM, 160 by 3 you will get, no, 160 by 3 meter. This is the range of the body along the inclined plane. I think in this way you can do. In this way you can do the problems. Okay, 160 by root 3. Yeah, Pranav, you are right. Karthi, okay, you got, that is the answer. Okay, right. In this way you have to do the problems. Already I sent the problems also to you. I sent the assignment to you and this notes also to you in the morning only. At 7 o'clock only I sent to you. I think they are in your WhatsApp group. So you go through them and you see, you do those problems in assignment based on this concept. Okay. Okay, I am signing out because if I start the new problem, we cannot complete them. Okay. Yeah, okay. Mokshi, already somebody else received also. Somebody else means everyone received that problem. Somebody may see or may not be seen. Okay, so you go through that notes. Right, Nana. Have a nice day. Take care of you. I'm signing out.